Welcome to Studio Biology. In this video, I am going to discuss the eyes of frog. The eyes of frog are 2 in number. These are large sized and spherical. Now, the movement of eyeball. Movement of eyeball is controlled by 6 muscles. These muscles are known as extra ocular muscles. So the eyeball movement, each eyeball is basically controlled by 6 extra ocular muscles. These are of 2 types. 2 are oblique muscles, while 4 are rectus muscles. These subtypes are, 2 oblique muscles are superior oblique and inferior oblique, while the 4 types of rectus muscles are superior rectus, inferior rectus, lateral rectus and medial rectus. So these are 6 types of muscles attached to each eyeball of frog. In addition, there are some more muscles like frog can protrude its eyes with the help of levator bulbi muscle. Levator bulbi muscle. While the frog can retract its eyes with the help of retractor bulbi muscle. And 1/3 of the eyeball, that is exposed part, is transparent. This region is transparent, while the 2/3 of the eyeball, which is concealed part, is opaque. Now the coats or layers of eyeball. These are 3. That is, first one is sclerotic or cartilage, the middle one is choroid, and the innermost is retina. So first of all, we'll discuss the sclerotic. Sclerotic is the outermost layer. It is outermost. It is thick and fibrous, made up of white fibrous connective tissue. Then it is also having cartilage. Then it is protective in nature. The anterior part of sclerotic continues with cornea, and cornea is covered by conjunctiva. Here we can see that this one is cornea, and up to here this is sclera or sclerotic layer, which continues anteriorly as cornea, And just above the cornea, conjunctiva is there. Then both cornea and conjunctiva are lubricated by Hardarian glands. So these glands perform the lubrication of the cornea and conjunctiva, and these glands are located in the orbit. Then second layer is choroid. Now some important points about the choroid are: it is richly vascular, it is pigmented, darkly pigmented, and it gives rise to iris and ciliary body. We can observe in the diagram, this one is iris and this structure is ciliary body. So posteriorly it gave rise to ciliary body, and anteriorly, posteriorly means in comparison to iris, ciliary body is posterior, although both are directed anteriorly. So first one is iris. Iris is a vertical circular and pigmented disc encircling pupil. So pupil is a cavity which is present in between the iris, and this pupil iris controls the amount of light entering the eyes. Now the next is ciliary body. Ciliary body is having ciliary muscles and a large crystalline a spherical lens is attached to ciliary body with the help of suspensory ligaments. Very important, suspensory ligaments. So we can observe, these are the suspensory ligaments, and this is the ciliary body having the ciliary muscles. Now important thing is that the last layer, which is very important, is retina. Now the last layer or innermost layer is retina. Retina is photosensitive layer. It is innermost layer. It is photosensitive. And it is having following layers. It is also divisible into different layers. These layers are: first one is the pigmented layer of cells. It is the outermost layer. Then comes the inner layer of rods and cones. Then, inner to rod and cones, there are many layers of sensory cells. And finally, the innermost layer is known as nerve fiber layer. This nerve fiber layer finally leads to the optic nerve of that eyeball. Now, there are few important terms. Blind spot. Now, this blind spot is that part of eyeball. It represents that part of eyeball from where the neurons from nerve fiber layer, nerve fiber layer is the innermost layer of retina, leave the eyeball as optic nerve. So there are no rods and cones in this area, so it is not meant for vision, but it is just outlet to the optic nerve. Another important area in retina is yellow spot. Now, what is this yellow spot? It is the most sensitive part of retina and it forms the most distinct image. So, most distinct image is formed in this area. So, this is all about the eyeball of frog. Thanks for watching this video.